April 17, 2018. LaGuardia Airport. Boeing 737-7H4 airliner Southwest Airlines. Preparing for flight 1380 on the New York San Francisco route. 144 passengers and 5 crew members are boarding the aircraft. The aircraft is being piloted by a crew consisting of Captain 56-year-old Tammy J. Schultz, a very experienced pilot. She served in the U.S. Navy, where she flew A-7 and F-18 fighters. She worked for Southwest Airlines for 24 years. And the total number of raids was 11,715 hours. Co-pilot 44-year-old Darren L. Ellisor, with a total flight time of 9,508 hours. 3 flight attendants worked in the passenger cabin of the aircraft. At 10:43 a.m., flight WH-1380 took off from New York and began climbing. But after 20 minutes of flight, while flight WH-1380 was at an altitude of about 32,808 feet and flying over the city of Benville, Pennsylvania, there was a sudden failure of the left engine, after which the plane began to spontaneously roll to the left. And after 6 seconds, the fuselage depressurization alarm went off in the cockpit. As it was later established, the left engine and engine nacelle were destroyed, while one of the separated parts of the engine nacelle knocked out the window in the passenger cabin, causing explosive depressurization. Within 11 seconds, the left bank reached its peak value, 41 degrees, after which the co-pilot, being the piloting member of the crew on this segment of the flight, began to level the aircraft. The pilots then set both engines to idle, initiating an emergency descent, and then shut down the collapsed left engine. At 11:04 a.m., the captain reported the emergency to the air traffic controller.
Can, Southwest 1380.
Southwest 1380, what happened to you?
We have an engine fire.
Southwest 1380, got you. Report your decision.
Direct us to the nearest airfield.
Southwest 1380 Harrisburg Airport, 33 miles out, straight on approach. Southwest 1380 is understood. Report back. Southwest 1380.
However, due to the high noise level in the cockpit, the crew did not hear any information from the dispatcher. At the co-pilot's suggestion, the captain asked the controller to divert the plane to Philadelphia Airport, which was 65 miles from the plane's location. At 11:05 a.m., the air traffic controller cleared flight 1380 to Philadelphia. According to NTSB investigators, if the pilots had made the decision to land at Harrisburg Airport, it still would not have allowed them to significantly speed up the landing, since the liner could not have descended from a height of 32,808 feet in much less time. At 11:09 a.m., Captain Schultz took over control of the aircraft. Southwest Airlines rules state that single-engine landings must be made by the captain. The descent at maximum operating conditions caused a strong vibration in the structure of the damaged liner, and in order to reduce it, the captain was forced to reduce the speed of the aircraft from 272 to 232 knots. Due to doubts about the controllability of the aircraft, the captain decided to land with the flaps extended at 5 degrees. While the normal landing position is 30 degrees or 40 degrees, the quick reference handbook recommends 15 degrees for landing with one engine running. According to the captain, during the descent, she felt a lot of resistance at the helm. Since the Boeing 737-700 Quick Reference Handbook does not contain 5 degrees flap approach instructions, the captain took the 15 degrees flap approach speed of 159 knots as a starting point and added 19 knots on top, thus assuming approach speed of 179 knots. At 11:20 a.m., flight WH-1380 made a successful landing at Philadelphia Airport. At the time of landing, the speed of the aircraft was 171 knots. As noted in the NTSB report, maintaining control of the damaged aircraft required great effort from the piloting crew member due to the thrust asymmetry and significant aerodynamic asymmetry caused by the destruction of the engine nacelle. The head of the Philadelphia Airport Fire Department said that after landing, the liner had a jet fuel leak from a destroyed engine and a small fire, which was quickly contained. Separated fragments of the engine nacelle were found near Bentonville. The WH-1380 flight was the first fatality in Southwest Airlines history and the first U.S. fatality in over 9 years since the DHC-8 crash near Buffalo on February 12, 2009, with 50 fatalities. Sitting next to the broken window was Jennifer Reardon, 43, Vice President of Public Relations at Wells Fargo in Albuquerque. The force of explosive decompression pushed the woman out of the plane, as a result of which her upper torso was outside the fuselage. Flight attendants immediately after the depressurization proceeded to their regular places to use oxygen masks. After that, putting on individual oxygen devices, they immediately began to bypass the passenger cabin to assist passengers. One of the stewardesses during the detour found a passenger thrown out to the waist. Together with another flight attendant, she tried to pull the victim back, but the pressure difference did not allow it. Two male passengers, Timothy McGinty and Andrew Needham, came to the rescue. Together they managed to drag the injured passenger inside the cabin. Many passengers tried to plug the knocked out porthole with improvised items, but these items were immediately thrown out of the plane. Retired nurse Peggy Phillips was among the passengers, and she, along with Andrew Needham, a qualified ambulance technician, began CPR on Reardon in an attempt to save her life 16 minutes before landing. The ER doctor later reported that the cause of the passenger's death was blunt trauma to the head, neck, and torso that was incompatible with life. 8 other passengers received minor injuries. They received medical attention at the Philadelphia airport but were not hospitalized. The U.S. Federal Aviation Administration has delayed on the ground all flights that were supposed to take off before 2 p.m. from Philadelphia International Airport. After the incident, another Boeing 737-7H4, flight N921WN, continued the flight WH-1380 from Dallas to New Orleans, but the flight number was changed to WH-8874. On April 17, 2018, the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration and the National Transportation Safety Board, NTSB, sent their experts to Philadelphia to investigate the causes of the incident. And on April 18th, the European Aviation Safety Agency, together with the FAA, demanded an inspection of all Boeing 737 engines around the world. The French Bureau for Investigation and Analysis of Civil Aviation Safety, BEA, also sent experts to assist in the investigation as the aircraft's engine-producing country. The final report of the NTSB investigation was released on November 19, 2019. According to the report, the cause of the accident was a fatigue crack in the root of the left engine fan blade. The development of the crack led to the separation of the blade. The blow of the detached blade into the fan housing led to the destruction of a part of the engine nacelle and the separation of its large fragments. One of the large detached fragments of the hood hit the side of the fuselage near the porthole, which caused the porthole glass to detach from the fuselage and led to a rapid depressurization of the fuselage and death of the passenger. In turn, the occurrence of a crack in the blade root was caused by the fact that the actual operating loads in it exceeded the loads assumed during the design. Also in the report, the NTSB Commission recognized the compliance of the crew's qualifications with U.S. regulations and the expediency of the crew choosing Philadelphia Airport Flight 1380 for an emergency landing. Deviations from the established flight procedures made by the pilots were recognized by the NTSB Commission as acceptable, taking into account the nature of the emergency and the amount of psychophysical stress on the crew. Of the operations not performed by the crew, only the release of spoilers could have an impact on the situation, according to the NTSB Commission. By releasing the spoilers, the crew could accelerate their descent without increasing airspeed, which could, if they chose Harrisburg Airport, make an emergency landing faster. However, the commission considers it unlikely that the time one would somehow change the consequences of the incident. On the other hand, according to the commission, the release of spoilers, in this case, could aggravate the violation of the aerodynamics of the aircraft associated with damage, thereby causing additional problems with stability and controllability. Renowned Captain Chesley Sullenberger, who successfully splashed down an Airbus A320 onto the Hudson River in 2009, praised the composure of Flight 1380 Captain Tammy J. Schultz. U.S. Transportation Secretary Elaine Chao released a statement in which she thanked the pilots who landed the plane safely, as well as the crew and passengers who provided support and assistance to the injured and prevented the worst. And U.S. President Donald Trump, at a personal meeting in the White House, expressed gratitude to the crew of Flight 1380 and the passengers who assisted passenger Jennifer Reardon. Southwest Airlines paid the passengers of the tragic flight $5,000 each and issued a $1,000 voucher as compensation for subsequent flights. Thanks to the composure, well-coordinated work of the crew, the pilots in an emergency did everything possible and safely landed the plane, avoiding a disaster.